Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Siege of Dragonspear Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatarine. We've just welcomed Glint into our party, and shortly before that, Viconia. Hopefully they work out.
What?
Let's talk to some other people around here, namely Rafus.
A simple matter.
How may I be of service?
How did you come to join this expedition? Paladins and mercenaries serve different masters.
When all serve a righteous cause, the cause becomes one. I tolerate the less savory elements of this expedition, because ultimately, they too will fight for the greater good.
That's pretty flexible of you. Paladins are not known for their flexibility.
We less savory elements appreciate your tolerance.
Rafa says, I know little of Kalar beyond the heresies he speaks. She claims no single god or pantheon as her own, but professes to act on behalf of them all. Whatever her goals, her heresies are an abomination. She invites the wrath of the gods down upon Toril. That's like their word for Earth. The name of this world, the entire world is Toril. You give me renewed faith for the task before us, Sapphire. I ask your leave now to pray. And he disappears. Now, the music's kind of getting annoying to me when it kind of blasts into full gear like that. We already have it down pretty far. Let's put it down a little bit more. At least. Alright. Let's talk to Belagarm.
I have many fine wares.
Alright, he's the merchant, so he came with us. Okay, good to know. Oh no, does Glint need armor? If you need anything during the journey to Dragonspear, come find me and I'll see what I can do.
You called?
So he has leather armor plus two. That's pretty good. I mean, that might be better than what Safana has. She just has regular leather. We should probably find her some better leather armor, right? Can we afford it? I mean, how much? Yeah.
I'm the best. You want me? Whatever you like.
An army marches on its stomach.
Studded leather armor plus one. That's gonna be better. Hopefully it is. No. Wait, what does she have? It's because of the bracers, isn't it? Yes, it's because of the bracers. Well, maybe someone else could use these bracers then. These are AC 5, they're even better. AC 7? I figured they wouldn't help me, otherwise I'd probably already be wearing them. And hers are better. I'll hold on to these in case we get another member. We might be able to use them. I'm not completely sure if Glint's gonna stay in the party. I'd rather have another fighter, to be honest with you is we already have a thief and we already have a cleric.
Sweetheart?
So that was kind of a loss, but I'm going to keep it as is.
I deserve to be leader.
Let's talk to these assorted Flaming Fist people.
Yes, dear.
See what they have to say.
We're more than mercenaries.
Sorry, I can't talk. Duty calls beyond yonder tree.
We're more than mercenaries.
My blisters have blisters. Want to see them? Here, look at them. Look at my blisters. That's okay.
Order is what matters.
The next trick is to reach Coastway Crossing before the Crusade.
We're more than mercenaries.
I can't be seen talking with you. No offense, but we've all heard the rumors, and I've got to work with these people. There's a chest here. Can I just go in these? Potion of healing and heroism. This chest isn't real. Soralis is over there. I gotta distribute these potions. 17 gold and a scroll of cure serious wounds. Just in case. Right, we've got 15 extra healings. He has 3. Not used to him being there in the order. Oh, he's already got 3. Might as well use up that wand. Okay. Can we just take this stuff? I mean, look, we've got full plate. Oh, is this my? This is my. Yes, we can just take this stuff. This is my stuff. Full plate. Now, fortunately, it requires 15 strength. Vaconia can't use that, but it's armor class 1.
Yes, Abel.
And this is armor class 1. So the only other person who could use that is Minsk. And he's got this, which is even better. So, and we don't need any of that stuff. It's funny. I'm worried about being attacked for opening my own chest.
Yes?
Alright, so let's talk to Petrescus.
A simple matter.
This and that to be done. No time to stay and chatter.
Well met, my friend. And how's this evening find you? Yet he chatters anyway. Well, thanks. We had this conversation before. I was hoping we'd have a different one. You're more than a simple adventurer now. You've become a symbol. People cheer your name and look to you for hope. 'Tis a great responsibility, a greater burden than I'd ever want to bear. I read that before. Fog again.
Oi, hero! I'll have words with you!
I can't resist. Any particular words, or shall we just select them randomly? Water. Xylophone. Crepuscular. Oh, that's a good one.
Don't forget xylophone. Oh, wait, you said that already.
I love it. Fox says, you think you're funny, do you? I have my moments.
Not as many as you like to think.
Really, Safana? Shush. Fox says, you stole my Ferdurkin drow. Give her back, or by Abathur, I'll split you in two, crown to crotch.
Viconia is her own person, Durgar. Thou hast no claim upon her.
She's defending Viconia. Here, I thought she didn't like her. The hells I don't. She wouldn't even be here if not for me. You don't just get to shuffle in and steal her out from under my nose without so much as a buy or leave.
Be gone. I want nothing more to do with you.
Wow. Told him. Alright, let's talk to Mizana.
I am Mizana, faithful of Tempus. Praise be to the Lord of Battles.
What's a cleric of Tempus doing here? Stealing soldiers for the coming battle, saving the anticipation of certain glory, waiting for the call of my lord. In that order? You have the look of one who has known many battles, yet you are clearly no soldier. What would you have of me? Tell me more about the Lord of Battles. What is there to tell? Be fearless. Do not run from the fight. Obey the rules of war. Those are his commandments. What are the rules of war? Do not resort to craven tricks or dishonorable tactics. You must respect all with the potential for valor, even the foe whose life you must take. Do this, and Tempest will look upon you with favor, for you will have defended your hearth, and still may you hold your head high. Do not run from the fight, so never retreat. One does not wage war recklessly. Retreat when you must, but do not avoid the battle when it rears before you. Win, and win decisively. So you fear nothing? What should I fear? War? War is a natural force, the storm that civilization brings by its very existence. I shall laugh at its thunder, and ride its winds for as long as I am able. One day I shall die, and I will go to my god gladly, knowing I served him well. There is nothing to fear in such a life. So why do you follow Tempus? We all respond to the call in our own way, do we not? Mine came to me early in life. I loved the thrill of battle, the excitement running through my veins as I faced my enemy. My family thought I was destined to be a soldier. Tempus showed me otherwise. It was not the first time I discovered my path was not what everyone believed it should be. I have no more questions. Then I trust you shall take your leave. What services do you offer? Quartermaster Belagarm handles supplies. I may be able to help you with cleric services, though. The Lord of Battle's favor is a handy thing to have, especially in times like these. Okay. Alright, so she can raise dad and all the normal things. Not selling anything, though. Like, I guess that's Belagarm's duty. Well, thank you. Rain is coming down. We should continue our conversations. Talk to this, Thaird.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
I've never heard that line before. Looking for a place to rest, hero? I can find you room in one of these tents. What do you do here? I assist the quartermaster in properly distributing the camp supplies. I'm in charge of tents, sleeping rolls, blankets, and the like. Can I find you a place to sleep? Not right now. Let me know if you want to rest later on. Although we could stand to memorize these spells. But, well, there's something else here as well. Locked. Safana?
Right.
What such menial tasks?
You're right.
Okay, so in here we have a bastard sword and a bunch of throwing axes. Nothing we need. Let's talk to Sarevok.
Such menial tasks.
Good day, and hello to you.
Greetings, hero. I'm Sarevok, a wizard employee of the Flaming Fist. What exactly do you do in camp? I provide arcane support to the troop and help advise the commanders on magical matters. I'm not a merchant, but if you require gear, you can speak to Quartermaster Belagarm. Have a good day.
I much prefer wooded regions, but one must be flexible in these times.
Well, some trees about. I have several tasks keeping me busy, but I can spare a moment if you need anything. Nothing right now, thank you.
Order is what matters.
Cover the supplies with tarps in case it rains. The weather out here is unpredictable.
We're more than mercenaries.
How long do you think we'll be camped here? Kalar's on the move. We should be too.
Order is what matters.
1, 2, 3, 4. March, 2, 3, 4. Report, soldier. The Coastway Bridge is to the northeast. Wolves and goblins spotted in the western woods. Refugees near a burned-out inn up the path. Carry on, then. Aye, sir. Alright, I guess we'll get our rest before we head on.
Me timber's bad enough without ye bothering me.
Okay. Maybe you shouldn't be saying like that if you're in charge of us finding places to rest. I want to rest. I'm sure I can find you some room. Wow, we have peasant and merchant accommodations. The hell? Okay, I'm dreaming about my encounter with Sarevok.
You did not think me truly dead, did you?
Well, apparently you live on in my thoughts.
We've a bond between us, you and I. A connection even the sharpest blade cannot sever. A bond forged in blood, hatred, death. I held the sword coast by its throat. It wriggled and squealed in my grip. And then... you.
Yeah. Then me.
I should have killed you, as I had so many others.
You tried.
But something stayed my hand. A weakness I had never known before.
And the rest was history.
Are we one and the same, my sister? One soul in two bodies, born of the Lord of Murder?
I'm pretty sure I have a separate soul from you.
We will never end, you and I, even in death.
You are not but ashes, Sarevok. Return from whence you came, and bother me no more.
You understood none of this, did you?
The hell are you doing here?
Do you see now?
Oh!
Your actions are
me.
As ill-judged
me.
As they are incomprehensible.
This cannot stand. This will not stand.
Edwin? So Edwin is here. What is... So the Hooded Man says we're supposed to understand something. I mean, I know we're both from the same... father? Baal? Sarevok, saying he's not possibly truly dead. There's a bond. Forged in blood, hatred, death, that the sharpest blade cannot sever. He held the sword coast by its throat, and then I interfered. He should have killed me. He had a weakness he had never known before. We're one and the same. It will never end, even in death. And then the Hooded Man said, we understood none of this. Maybe it has something to do with his weakness. I'm not sure. Alright, so in any case, Edwin is here for some reason. I'm not having him join us in our party. We already have two magic users.
A simple matter.
He was in our party briefly. Back in Nashkel.
Eh? What is this? Where did you come from? Careful, Odessiron. You can trust no one.
Oh, he's talking to himself. I'll find a new skull to house your worthless eyes. Can't say I ever heard that one. Was that you were saying? Are you talking to yourself? I was speaking to no one. Well, until now, when you interrupted my path and my thoughts. Do you not know who I am? I am Edwin Odessaron. I think that's how I said it. Pride of the Red Wizards and the greatest son of Thay. I realize your monkey brain cannot grasp the importance of this event, so I shall simply order you to show respect. Do not look upon me. Do not speak to me. Simply bow and step aside. Do you understand my words? A nod will do. Oh, boy. We've met before, Edwin. Don't you remember? Wait. Sapphire? What business brings you here? The crusade of Kalar Arjun in the north. I intend to stop it before it spreads. It seems fate has offered you to me. The Shining Lady follows me, and you seek to kill her. Our interests align, and should you fail, well, no harm is done, and I am as I was. I have no interest, but, Kalar's chasing you? She's near here?
Thou runnest, or should I say, waddlest, away from the Shining Lady?
Yeah, Dinah here hates, Edwin. Edwin Odessaron does not run, nor does he waddle, you dusky-skinned harlot.
Your words would be those of a wise man. A wise man whose butt needs kicking.
Prepare to meet your heathen gods. Know this, mage. To attack Dinah here is to attack me. What? You would side with this witch? Against the Great Odessaron?
Fool that you are. Feel the power of the Red Wizards unleashed.
Okay, apparently now we're attacking Edwin. Right then.
Yes?
Yes, yes?
What is it?
Well,
Fine.
I'm gonna take over there, tuck
Time
off
to go?
For there, and... Silence? That was quick. Don't take any of my stuff, he says.
Yes?
Don't cast that.
Uh-huh. Hey, you bet.
Well, I was
you show such devotion to your companions. Your witch and your hamster, is it? It's an appealing trait you have.
Talking to Minsk?
Oh, what game do you play here, evil elf lady? It will take more than compliments to make Minsk trust you.
The barbarian's not completely without sense. Who'd have thought?
You are too suspicious, pale one. I merely made an observation.
You do more than that. You said loyalty is appealing. But Minsk has heard that drow betray each other at every turn.
Oh, they do. That is why your loyalty appeals.
I love it. That was awesome. Anyway.
What is it?
I? Yes.
That was the most awesome conversation. All he has is a quarter staff. Really? Well, no wonder we killed him so easily. No special mage robe or anything? Damn. Alright. So up the road is an inn with refugees, Tiki-san?
What? Such menial tasks.
Oh, who's this? Prin. Let's talk to Prin. Oh, hello. Apologies for not greeting you sooner. I was a bit distracted. Didn't notice you? Was she singing? Were you singing to that rock? I probably look a little strange, don't I? This is a very unusual stone, though. It fascinates me. It looks old. What's that writing carved upon it? I wish I could tell you. It's not natural. I was walking the coast way, singing as I worked out a new song, when I heard the stone humming. Intriguing. Was it humming a particular song? Perhaps trying to communicate with you? At first, I thought I might be going mad, but there are menhirs like this all over the side of the crossing. They all responded to my humming. Okay, now, I don't know what this word means, but I have heard it before. When I sing to more than one, their tones last longer. They stop eventually, though. I try to find all of them, but the forest is too dangerous. So for journal update for ancient menhirs. Can you tell me exactly where you found the menhirs? I'd be happy to mark their location on your map. Anything for another elf. Sweet. Elf power. Anything else I can help with? May I sing to your menhir? I see no reason why not. Just go right up to it and sing. Yeah, I'll watch out for these menhirs. If you find them all and learn why they're singing, could you return and let me know? Of course. I'll be here, singing to the stone. I need to find all 6 ancient menhirs in the area. To unlock the mystery of the musical menhirs and discover what their purpose is, I must first find all the ancient menhirs in the area, then sing to them until they emit a pleasing tone. Well, that's surprising.
It would be a beautiful night, but for that wretched moonlight.
Hey, the moonlight's awesome. Runes eroded by time mark one face of this tall stone menhir. An image on its surface shows a man with a billowing cloud issuing from his mouth. And then something. The menhir emits a constant low-pitched hum. I would tell her to try, but I don't want to tell her she's charming. Hello, can you understand me? Is this thing on? Hum at the menhir. Oh, God. The menhir's hum turns to a bone-chilling wail. That didn't sound good. What? There's a... That's a groundhog. Oh, there's a wraith here. Attacking Minsk.
Yes?
Zahar!
Oh, level drain. No good. Princess Dory, me. Alright, we need to heal his level drain.
Fine.
Oh, without this fog, does that have anything to do with it? Or is that just random? We might have made the fog, I'm not sure. Lesser Restoration. Minsk is fatigued, though.
Yes?
I mean, I don't know if he was level 9 or not.
What is it? Fine.
Alright. Maybe it doesn't like humming? Or I'm just not good at singing? Maybe we need a bard. Or someone with a particularly good... We'll try singing. Now, what's it say? An image on its surface shows a man with a billowing cloud issuing from his mouth. A second man, clad in robes, stands with his arm outstretched, and magical energy flying from his hand. The energy has struck the cloud and divided it into 6 pieces. Billowing cloud.
What? Fine. Yes, fine.
People in the way or something.
What is such menial tasks?
I can't affect it now?
Ah, fresh air and the beauty of nature. So, how long do we have to stay out here?
Yes.
Safana, it...
What? Fine.
Did mention...
You cannot
hey
stop
there.
Yawning, and
yes,
it's making
dear.
Me... Yeah, do. Perhaps we could rest.
All right. I don't know. Doesn't seem like we have an option. It is 5 a.m.
Yes, a simple matter.
Minsk is tired from his level drain, so I guess we'll rest again. Where's, what's his name?
Boo likes the forest. And I do too. There is much to nibble here.
Oh, here he is.
Your chattering's starting to wear on me nerves.
Shut up and give us a place to rest. Alright, so he's... Level 8. He doesn't need anything.
Boo says you smell rotten to the core. And Boo's nose has never let me...
Keep your distance or suffer the consequences.
She literally interrupted him.
What is it? Such menial tasks.
I love their banter back and forth. I just want to check to make sure he still doesn't need this. Apparently he does. He's level 8 with 161,333. So it fatigues him, but it doesn't appear to do anything else. I want to see something then. Hold up. So just gonna check. 194,401. That's me. I didn't have level drained. So now I'm fatigued. Is that the same? And it is using up our money. Obviously I'm going to restore the quick save. I just want to see 194,401. I would think that it would restore an entire level. But maybe not. 194,401. Yeah, we're paying for it. And it's not doing anything to us. Alright, so. Yeah, it's no good.
Such menial tasks.
But Minsk is fatigued again. This is not working the way it's supposed to. I want to see what the description is, actually, if we can see that. The casting of this spell is very draining on the priest, and she will likely require rest immediately after the casting, as will cause days worth of fatigue almost instantaneously. Okay, yet the one being fatigued is the target. Mizana should be the one fatigued, not Minsk. And we seem to pay for it when it has no effect.
What? A simple matter?
Really just resting again to get rid of Minsk's fatigue.
I need a swig of some strong dwarven ale.
Okay. Walk not so close to me, Kivel.
Do not distract me with such trivialities.
Laconia says.
Yes, a simple matter.
I don't like traveling under dark that much, but... Should we try this stone again?
What fine?
Can we? I can't seem to do anything with it at this point. Okay.
What? Such menial tasks.
Brielle. We haven't talked to Brielle, have we?
Order is what matters.
Oh! Didn't realize she had a name. Keeping your skills sharp, I see. Doesn't do to get soft, not at all. The battle will come sooner we think. Hup, 2, 3, 4. Carry on then. Alright. Actually, I'm gonna call it an episode here. We're gonna look for this inn or something to that effect with refugees down the road here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.